friends, in this lecture I am going to explain vapor pressure of liquid solution. Okay, so we can simply define that vapor pressure is nothing but a pressure exerted by the vapor. Okay, the pressure exerted by the vapor above the liquid surface at a equilibrium at a given temperature, simply we can call it vapor pressure. Okay, to easy to understand the vapor pressure, just now look at here, I am taking one of the liquid solution, and this liquid solution I am taking a beaker and I am closing with a jar. Okay, generally volatile liquid can easily evaporate. So for example, I am taking that volatile liquid here. Okay, this volatile liquid, it is containing the surface with all that volatile. For example, I am taking the pure solvent, a volatile solvent is there. So this surface area, this liquid surface area is containing all the volatile solvent particles. These are ready to escape from the liquid solution and occupy this empty space in the jar. Okay. So some of that solvent particles are escaping from the liquid and occupying some space which are containing that empty jar. Okay. So after some time, these are going to condense again, these are coming into that liquid. So at the particular, it is attaining an equilibrium. Okay. So that's why I am saying that the pressure exerted by the vapor over liquid, okay, so above the liquid surface at equilibrium at a given temperature, usually we can call that vapor pressure. Okay. So this vapor pressure mainly depends on two conditions. One, just you can check the temperature. Okay. And another one is the nature of liquid. Nature of liquid. So generally when you increase the temperature, the kinetic energy of these solvent molecules, the volatile solvent I am taking here, the kinetic energy of this volatile solvent increases, easily escape from the liquid, and it's going to become such a vapor, and these vapors are exerting the pressure, that vapor pressure is going to increases. Okay, so while increasing the temperature, vapor pressure is going to increases. And another factor, it is depends on nature of liquid. So here the different type of liquids have the different magnitude of vapor pressure. So why? Because these liquids are containing some strong intermolecular attractions, or some are containing the weak intermolecular attractions. So the liquid which are containing the weak intermolecular attractions, they, it is easy to escape from the liquid and easily going to become such a vapor. So when the more solvent particles or the more volatile solvent particles are when ready to escape from the liquid, it is going to become more vapors. So more vapors are exerting that more pressure. So that's why the nature of liquid, nothing but which have weak interactions, those are showing that more vapor pressure. Got it? Okay. And here I am giving that, I would like to compare the vapor pressure of a pure solvent and a solution. A solution which is containing non-volatile solute. Just here I would like to compare that a vapor pressure of a pure solvent which is containing a volatile solvent. For this volatile solvent, when I am adding a non-volatile solute, the vapor pressure is going to decreases. So why? So when you comparing between these two, here I have only pure solvent. In the pure solvent, the liquid surface area, the liquid surface is containing all the solvent particles. The number of solvent particles are more. When the number of solvent particles are more, these are ready to escape easily. More number of particles we can expect from this surface. But when you are adding a non-volatile solute for this, okay, the surface, generally it is in a volatile solvent. For this volatile solvent, when you are adding a non-volatile solute, the surface occupies with some solute particles. When you are adding a non-volatile solute to the volatile solvent, here the number of solvent particles are going to decrease. When number of solvent particles are going to decrease, Here, the number of particles escape from liquid also decreases. Now let's see here. Here I have a more number of vapor particles, but here I have less number of vapor particles. Why? Because the surface occupied with some non-volatile solute. Okay. So generally, when you comparing the vapor pressure of pure solvent, if I am taking that a P naught, if I am showing that vapor pressure of solution PS, okay, so always P naught is greater than PS. Okay, pure solvent vapor pressure generally greater than solution which containing non-volatile solute. Got it? So simply we are defined that vapor pressure. Vapor pressure is nothing but a pressure exerted by the vapor above the liquid surface at equilibrium at a given temperature. Usually we can call vapor pressure. Okay. So this is simple phenomena, more useful to understand. Okay. The colligative properties. Clear?